In Matthew chapter 6, verse 63, these words I speak unto you, they are spirit. I want life. Anybody want your life to be better?
Amen.
These words I speak, I want to be steadfast. I want to be a mover. Anybody here want to be a shaky person? Want to be sick in your walk with God? He said, these words I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Now turn with me to Romans. I'm going to open this passage, chapter 8, verse 35. And I want you to stand while I read it. Romans chapter 8. For the church, I'm going to be steadfast. I'm going to say this to you. The race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. Anybody want to win?
Yes.
Tell somebody next to you, I'm a winner. Anybody want to win in everything?
Amen.
Amen.
Anybody here from Dunbar?
Yeah.
I'm not going to talk about it because I got some fine Colonel White, Thurgood Marshall members here. Y'all know. But forgive us. Can anybody gut it out? I saw where a team came 18 points down and won. Steadfast. Humble. Stand focused. Can you wait on God? Lord, I need to hear some threes. The writer said here, what shall separate us from the love of God? A very powerful scripture. Let me just share it with you. And I hear the Lord say to you this morning, I need some steadfast hope. I'm moving. Strong. I want somebody on my team.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The clutch players. Two o'clock in the morning, they ready to happen. My wife and I meet done that. Matter of fact, I went to the hospital and went with my pajamas on. Forgot. I don't know whether they praised me in that or not. I had them on under my pants. Reverend, that's okay. You're there. Strong, mighty, unified body. Church with focus, church that's steadfast.
Amen.
Which means if you're steadfast with God, God says, I make you and your wife steadfast in marriage and I fill the gaps.
Amen.
Let's just talk about that. If you can't close the gap, God says, I cause a breach. Then you're lying. I want you to hear this. I thought this was the most powerful scripture. Verse 35 says, who shall separate us from the love of God? Look what it says here. Shall shall tribulation. The stress. Yeah, I like that. You answer that. Persecution. Famine. Nakedness. Peril. Sword. Like somebody went through something. My God. Such a point. What it says, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Which means when the sheep will go there, they said nothing. God needs some members like that. Amen. Non-complainers. No murmurers. Who know their call.
Yes.
And God, I'm here.
Amen.
I'm here for witnessing. I'm here for knocking on doors. I'm here for prayer walking. Pastor, just give me something to just tell me a suggestion. I'm retired. I'm not doing much. I'm laid off on my job. General office are closed. Pastor, you tell me God and count cards and pray. It don't get too low for me. Honey, you're going to see the flowing of the power of Jesus.
Amen, amen.
Pastor, I can't do anything but just clean up the toilets. I work with the children's church. I work with seniors. I make phone calls to those who are sick. Give me something to do. I want to feel the power because I want the Lord to work with me. Look what he says here. Naming all of these things. How many want to be more than a conqueror in Jesus Christ?
Amen.
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 More than a conqueror. Listen, when you get to glory, Sister Rick Straw, come here. See, this is covered today because I want the hand of God to be upon my life in the year 2010. If you're here today, I don't want you to be ashamed nobody's looking, but I want you to say, Brother Preacher, I want you to pray for me, and I want you to get it together. And Pastor, you know, I'm going to grab a hold to the gospel plow without looking back because I want to be fit for the kingdom of you here today. And I just want you to just lift that right hand. I want to pray for you. He said, Brother Preacher, I want to recommit. And I see your hands. And anyone else, I see your hands. And I see your hands. I need to see about five more hands. I need to go up. There's another hand. There was another hand. Thank you. I said, is there another hand? Thank you, Jesus. To my right and to your left. Pastor, I really want to get it right with God. I really want to trust it because I said that God want to do something great and mighty for me this year. Amen. And I want to prophesy this over your life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. What I'm going to ask you to do, hallelujah, I want to pray for you, but I want to pray for you up close. Anyone who said, Pastor, well, I'm not a member of anyone's church, and I want to give God my heart and all of that, but Pastor, I've been looking for a church that would challenge me, that would cause change in my life, and the church that would care for me. If you're here today, to Brother Preacher, I want this church to be my church. I just want you to raise your right hand, and I want to pray for you, and I see your hand in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I see your hand in the back. Praise